worsening flood crisis in Victoria. In Wangaratta, some residents have been ordered to evacuate as the levee threatens to burst. At Shepparton, the town is on high alert, with up to 60 homes expected to be evacuated tonight. At Myrtleford, most of the town is submerged, with residents south of the town urged to evacuate. At Kyalla, the broken river has broken its banks. Horsham residents are being warned that the town could be inundated tonight. In Charlton, the Avoca River has burst its banks. The main street is flooded. While near Bairnsdale, authorities are watching flood levees in the McAllister and Mitchell rivers. 10's Alan Rascal is in Wangaratta tonight. Alan, what's the situation there with evacuations?
Sandra, a very anxious wait for the residents of Wilson's Road, not too far from where I'm standing here in Wangaratta. It is there that that levee is threatening to burst under the immense pressure from a massive wall of water following the weekend deluge that saw around 200 millimetres of rain dumped on parts of Victoria. Now, late this afternoon, residents were ordered to evacuate following an emergency briefing. They were told they had just 10 minutes to get home, get what they can, and to get out, although I'm told a number are ignoring that evacuation order. If that levee does break, a massive amount of water will spew into that street, up to 2 metres, and affect around 60 homes. Going into that emergency evacuation meeting this afternoon, residents were extremely concerned about the levee in question. Let's take a listen.
Because they said the levee bank was going to break, so we just had to come and find out, I suppose, what's happened.
There are these cracks in the levees. You know, when they were assured us that they'd hold back a 100-year flood.
We've had this dry and drought conditions for 8 to 10 years, and there's weaknesses being found the same as we've had with the rail line.
Now, more rain is predicted later in the week, which will no doubt add to the woes. Reporter Kate Creedon has more.
Described as Victoria's worst floods in 15 years, the crisis has now been elevated to a catastrophic event. Rivers swelling well above their banks and flooding town after town.
We were told to evacuate yesterday because the levee may not hold.
Across the state, almost 300 homes have been inundated by floodwaters caused by heavy rain and melting snow in the Alps, many unprepared when water started pouring into their homes in the middle of the night.
I went to bed at 11:30. Lenny came in at 1:30 and said there's water in the back of the house.
One stranded family had to be rescued from the rising waters by boat.
Never had to do that before, but a bit scary too, leaving the house and not knowing what's going to happen.
Since Friday, the SES has received some 4,500 calls for help. And for many towns, the worst is yet to come. The water's showing no sign of subsiding.
Yeah, we've never seen it like this before. This is just amazing.
Residents in affected communities spent much of the day doing all they could to prevent further damage. Others making the most of the situation. With limited access, several schools have closed and hospitals forced to move patients to higher ground.
They're moving some people out of houses and telling people to put up higher where the water's coming in.
The Army leading the relief effort. Also lending some muscle, Premier John Brumby. Those affected will receive government assistance, but the real cost of another natural disaster for the state is yet to be revealed.
I did speak to the Prime Minister yesterday. The federal government will be working with us to share the costs of this. I'm not going to put a number on it, but it'll be tens of millions of dollars.
Kate Creedon, 10 News.